Hey Samurais, how are you doing today? Today we're going to talk about long-term archiving and backing up your footage after you're done shooting. If you guys could do me a big favor before we start, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, share these videos with your friends. If you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed. And if you are subscribed, make sure you hit that little bell so you get all the notifications when we post new videos or go live. Also, make sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and LinkedIn so you can stay up to date with everything we're doing. So today I want to start off by talking about how to back up and archive your footage. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain to you our process. Then I want to know from you guys, how do you guys go about backing up and archiving your footage? So when we decided to start looking into how we're going to back up and archive our footage, we started out by talking to our insurance company, and then we actually brought a company in because we wanted to make sure that we were the most protected that we could be when it comes to protecting once-in-a-lifetime content. So our backup actually starts in the field. Most of our cameras actually offer dual recording, so it records to two SD cards, two hard drives, etc. If it's a camera that doesn't support that, we use an external recorder with that camera, so we always have two copies of that camera's footage when we're done shooting that day. The next part is when we get back to our studio. What happens? One of the copies stay at our studio, one of those copies move to an off-site location. So if our studio was to have a fire or a flood or something major happen to it, we don't lose all of the footage. Now the next part is actually editing. So now we have all of our project files and we have our raw footage that is on our computer. So all of our computers are backed up to a server at our studio, and then that server is mirrored at another server that is stored off-site. So if something again was to happen to our studio, we don't lose all of our footage. So it's a redundant backed up system. Plus, at the end of the day, all of the projects and raw files are also backed up onto a hard drive. So if those servers both were to get corrupted, we still have all the project files stored offline. So now let's quickly talk about long-term archiving of our projects and footage. So our first step to archiving has already kind of been done. It's the SD cards. We do not reuse our SD cards. We always keep the SD cards saved with the raw footage on them. So if we need to go 2, 3, 4 years back down the line to pull footage for that client for another project they're doing, we can. The next step is that hard drive that we've been backing up everything onto. We then duplicate that hard drive. So now we have two hard drives. That way we can store one on-site and one off-site, again, just in case anything was ever to happen to our studio. All right, guys, now that you know how I archive and back up my footage, let me know how you guys do it and what processes you put in place to make sure you stay safe and don't lose any of that precious footage. All right, until next time, remember to dream big, think bigger, and always be you.